At this point, you've heard hundreds of ChatGPT formulas, but some are better than others. But this one that we're talking about today is better than all of them. And the reason I'm able to say that confidently is because this one prompt we're talking about today is the mother of all prompts. It's going to allow you to take any use case and then generate a variety of other use cases from that one example. So essentially, this video is going to be showing you how to turn one prompt into as many examples as you want. And one more thing, at the end of this video, I'll be showing you how to use this to generate ideas. It's the best idea generator inside of ChatGPT that I have been able to discover yet. So make sure to not miss out on that part. One last thing before we start, and that is if you enjoy this YouTube channel, you would probably enjoy our other social media channels. Over the past 2 months, I've been building out a team around the AI Advantage brand, and we're now on both Instagram and TikTok with over 1 million views on TikTok on a video already. So feel free to follow us there if you use those platforms. You can find all the links, including the prompt that we'll be using today, in the description of this video. And with that being said, let's start exploring this. Okay, so here's the prompt that I've been refining over the last 2 months. Let's go through this step by step so you understand what you're getting yourself into here. Now generate use cases from a chatbot prompt formula. You will be turning a prompt formula like, write me a type of text with type of text in square brackets, indicating that that is the part to be replaced. Two, write me an essay. Okay, so that is the core block of this prompt. First, we let it know that we're going to be generating use cases from a formula, and then we provide an example of that formula and what the output is supposed to look like. By giving ChatGPT both of those, we take the guessing work out. But then we follow up with, always maintain the structure of the prompt formula and only replace the word in square brackets. And already we asked for a lot of specific things. Get us some use cases from formulas. Here's what a typical input and output looks like. And we put limits on it by saying only replace the words in square brackets and stick to the structure we present to you. And now we round out the prompt by saying now generate a list of 10 prompts without executing them for insert your prompt formula. So I'll just go over to my free ebook and take one of my prompt formulas here. And look, you could totally come up with formulas like this yourself from prompts that you use on a daily basis. But if you sign up to my newsletter, you can download this free ebook and you can simply copy paste 25 different formulas for ChatGPT prompts just like this. Okay, if we hit enter now, ChatGPT is going to generate a list of 10 use cases for this prompt that considers legal action. And there you go. Now you can generate as many examples as you want. But what a use case does this have beyond going on social media and selling your prompt examples just like this? Which, by the way, in that form, I never did. With my ebook, it's not just prompt examples, as many others sell them. I provide you with different use cases that include the formula.
Nice.
And now, if what you just learned, you could generate thousands of examples from a few formulas. But again, how do we put this to action if you're not just looking to come up with a giant list of prompt examples? Well, let's head on over to page 24, social media captions. And this is where it starts getting interesting because we have more than one variable. So again, let's take this use case generator prompt and add the social media captions formula behind it. And again, in the description, you can copy paste the formula. Plus, there's a link to get my free ebook. And if I hit enter, it starts getting real interesting because here we're asking for it to come up with adjectives, the type of media, and the subject. And this right here is simply put a better way to brainstorm ideas with ChatGPT than any other prompt I tried. Whatever brand you have, this can be a source of inspiration for maybe creating content that is based around the cartoon of a group of animals. That idea can be applied to essentially any brand, right? Or maybe you want to post some videos of puppies playing. So again, we're just using this formula to generate examples, but you might as well call these ideas, use cases. And if you want 10 more ideas, all we have to do is follow up with 10 more. And just because we went super meta and we're asking ChatGPT to generate instructions for ChatGPT, it doesn't mean we can't come back to Earth and actually ask it to do it. If you like one of these, simply tell it expand on number 10. And boom, it does it. Not just that you get 10 captions for a photo of a person hiking in the mountains. You also get a visual description that, by the way, you could plug into an image generator and get that image generated. And you get a full psychological profile of what that person would be feeling and how you connect with your customer more successfully. Okay, pretty insane if you ask me, but there's more. I'll just take the basic idea generator prompt. And here from page 20 in the ebook, we can copy this formula that has multiple variables in it. And this one is supposed to help you write a bio on a social media profile. And if we run this, as expected, it gives us various types of profiles with various characteristics catering to different audiences. But I need you to realize that you can take these formulas and always take out the variable. So let's say we're starting out a profile on Instagram for the AI Advantage. I would change the first variable to Instagram bio, and I would change the last variable to AI enthusiasts. And now we made the idea generator a little more focused. And voila, 10 ideas for social media content that I could not just create for the bio, but for our entire Instagram profile. Ability to apply AI concepts to real world problems, interest in the latest AI research, experience and expertise in AI programming. Every single one of these could be a different Instagram post or even the focus of an Instagram theme page if you're looking into starting anonymous accounts. And all you need to do after copy pasting the prompt from this video's description is turn the prompts that you use on a daily basis into formulas. And if you don't have any prompts that you use daily, or you just want more inspiration, you can get the ebook with 26 formulas from the description below. And this video will show you a more basic approach to implementing all these prompts into your everyday life. I hope this helped, and I'll see you soon.